Listen to me carefully, for the tale I'm about to tell still comes true at midnight hour. This is the tale of the haunted queen who knew not of her power. When the sun goes down and it's close of day, the queen leaves her throne and runs away. She says, I have no power without this crown. She shuts the door and makes no sound. In screaming woods and empty rooms, every night she sleeps in an empty tomb. Darkness visits her in her sleep, and her conscience got thrown out on the streets. The mighty ruler had lost her peace, and all because of this one little piece. She didn't believe in what she preached. She upheld women in her reign. Hers was a blend of Louise Mushikiwabo and Kamala Harris, from Rwanda to America to the world. Hers was a global terrain. She was the first queen ruler in chief, like the first female African president, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, a voice of change, like First Lady Janet Kagame, bouncing on cloud nines of praise. Building an empire was her wildest chase. Just like the women in Rwanda, turning this nation into an empire. When the world heard about the 1994 genocide, they heard a hopeful melody, a chanting of opportunity. It was a calling, and they were called to lead. But constantly they were told, this cannot be achieved. These queens saw a crown, but they were not allowed to wear it. Hell took flight like a violent hound. But this never laid low their spirits. Back to the story, the haunted queen. She ruled independently, she gleamed with pristine, the woman of the century, making her ascendancy supreme, setting her descendants free from oppression, considered foreign or insane, just because she spoke of gender role revaluation. What haunted her was not the crown she thought bore her power, it was society's expectations of her. Though she preached free women from oppression by day, it was not a story of her own in her home. And to this day, she rests in the dust of decay. But wait, the fortune teller enters the palace. I wish to inform you of an important occurrence. I believe it deserves your attention. I'd like to reveal the contents of my dream. A wonder of a revelation. So it seems, I, the fortune teller of this empire, have found the great blessing we were bestowed. Allow me, my queen, to give this decree. Heed to this message, for it bears your interest in part and the nation's on the other half. Listen, listen to me when I say, oh, come, come and see. The leader is not he or she, it is the genius in all human beings. Your role as a human being is not finite. You can cook, you can clean, you can rule, you can dream, you can do anything. Just like a queen, just like a king. And listen, for your power is not a mere crown, it is in fact you. It's you, the crown. Dearly beloved queen, since your smile makes fire float on the waters, I mean, your highness, name it, and I will climb towers. Now I am no climber, but Everest will know my name, for I am from the kingdom of Her Majesty, the Queen. But what's funny is that she smiles back when I smile at her, looks at me when I stare. To look at her, I will not dare, so when I turn away, she turns too. It's funny seeing ourselves in a mirror's view. I scrub my eyes and turn to see. Her Majesty has never looked more pretty, for Her Majesty is me.